Hey, welcome back to Football Manager 2016 Canada Edition. Right now we got Team Canada getting ready to go on holiday in Belize. You can see by our schedule down here we got some interesting away games coming up pretty soon here. Belize, Suriname, Cayman Islands. Montserrat, not sure where that is or what that is, quite honestly. Just click on an overview. See, it's another thing about this game is you get to learn things. They're 141st in the world. They speak English. Interesting stuff. Should be a world map. See where these guys are at. I don't know. We'll look that up. I generally know where most countries are at, but no friggin' crew. They gotta be an island, former British Isles. Not British Isles, but former British colony somewhere. I'm gonna say Pacific Island somewhere. It's gonna be my guess. Anyway, we're not playing them. We're playing Belize. There we go. The Jaguars. Ooh, they got a nickname. 175th. Tied for 175th in the world. So really, we had a friendly with Scotland planned, but they canceled. So I guess we just picked up a bunch of not great teams. And hopefully build some confidence. Do we have a nickname? Doesn't say. Does Canada have a nickname for their team? That is a good question. And we'll never know the answer to that question. Nation, there we go. Nickname the Canucks. We are the Canucks. I didn't think that that was really a nickname that they would use. Rivals, USA and Honduras. Interesting rivals. Did not know that. All kinds of things I didn't know about Canada. 53rd in the nation, so we should win. We should win this matchup. Anyway, let's look at our team selection. We got some tired fellers. Let's see who we can bring in there. We can bring in Diaz. Cruz, we'll swap positions there. Diaz likes to play on the left side. Maybe we could even put in Lubon instead. He's much better rated than Diaz for some reason. That's strange. I point this out every single time. The national team just has no faith in Diaz anymore. They rate him a 2-star guy, but my ratings is still a 3.5-star guy. I don't know. One of us is wrong. Either it's me or it's me. One of me's is wrong. Anyway, we got some midfielders now. Brought this guy, Talbert, up from the B team. He's a little old, but he's got some good skills. He can do corners and crosses. He's a good passer. Good technique, all that stuff. He's got some leadership abilities. So he's not a bad guy to have in the middle of your lineup. So I think I'll replace Wood, because Wood is a little bit tired. Let's see, what's his thing? Central midfielder? Sure, maybe. Deep lying playmaker? Nah, we'll just go central. Smith is okay. Everybody else is okay. So we got another new striker here, Israel Cantu. One of our dudes, our normal call-ups, his team refused to let him leave, the LA Galaxy. I think I have a feud with their coach or something. He didn't like that I played him too long in the last game, I know that. Sent me an email about, or no, he mouthed off to the press about it. So, went out and got Cantu, he's a good finisher. You know, he's got good all-around athletic abilities. He's not the greatest player in the world, but 23 years old. Good to have some youth on this old man's team that I assembled here. I don't think there's much else different that we've assembled. Gonna move Felipeño up to the advanced midfielder role. Couldn't find any great guys for that. I mean, we could put Ferguson in that role too if needed. But anyway, this team, we got options. We got people who can, you know, go different places. That was another reason why I wanted this Talbert character. Because look at that. He can play like every position except for central defense and goalie. So, like, we're covered now. We're not going to have the problems we had last time, where we just didn't have any midfielders. Now we got guys who can play all over the place. Alright, so let's go submit this team. Enough jibber jabbers. We got more MLS on the TV. Seattle and Sporting Kansas City. At least it's not Real Salt Lake, which is stupid. Like, why? I don't know. They've got these sort of Europeanized names that nothing particularly wrong with it. Hey, they're copying my style here. They're copying my style with the attacking diamond formation here. What's up with that? I'm starting a new trend. Nobody's ever played this formation ever. Now they're just biting off me, so we'll see. Anyway, they got these like names that just don't fit with other American sports. It's a little strange. Like, one of the few teams it does is like the New York Red Bulls. That's, even though it's named after a sponsor, which is not American, it's at least some sort of nickname. You know, it's not Toronto Football Club. Okay, Toronto FC. Fine, but, you know, we're used to nicknames. We're used to, like, the Toronto Argonauts or the Toronto Maple Leafs, Toronto Blue Jays. Of course, on the other hand, you could say all the good nicknames are taken, so I don't know. It's just different, and everyone fears change, me most of all. I expect nothing but a win. Haha. No, they didn't like that. Alright. Instructions. I guess we'll keep with our basic, what we've been doing. Especially against this team, we should be able to just manhandle them. Wow, that's an interesting little tiny stadium they got. This looks a lot like my second division, Toronto FC 2. Are those our fans in the back here? What's going on? Did we bring more fans than Belize? Oh, one burger to one ambulance. That is not good ratio. Not good ratio over here. Don't get your burgers from Belize, people. So it looks like we're in the whites today. That's different. Got all kinds of strange uniform choices for Canada. I don't know how they choose which uniforms to wear, honestly. The away teams have to wear white of some sort. Home teams wear some color. I don't know if that's how it is. There we go. There we go. Clement. He's one of the. Moved him to attacking midfielder. Just to see, see what he could do there. Interesting, interesting. Looks like they got a pretty decent defense. Kind of small, though, but. I guess we don't have any strikers that are good in the air anyway, so it doesn't much matter. Sosa's. I didn't realize he was so tired. Now that I know we get six subs, though, it's not such a big deal. I gotta get used to. What is this? I gotta get used to following the movement of the white shirts here. Just not used to that. Martinez, Knowles, a lot of familiar names here. Get there. Now get there. Putting on a lot of pressure. I like that. Gonna get a goal here soon. There was one article in the press that said this is such a mismatch, it's not even worth playing, but I do agree we need to get tested, but I think we also need to build up some rapport, get some wins under our belt, more specifically my belt, because I don't want to get fired. Also, I'm still having lots of problems with Toronto FC. There's like, I think there's four games left, and I'm three games out of the playoffs. I made a bunch of changes. I brought in a couple of guys. A bunch of my guys got healthy. Wow, nice shot. See, there's Dudek. There's what he's capable of. No, there's not what he's capable of. He missed that. Okay, never mind. So yeah, I went out, got some new players for Toronto just to try to make a playoff push, you know, and I got my good players back from injury, but we're still just not. There it is. There's Dudek. That one for real this time. Unless he was offside. No, not offside. So yeah, Toronto FC still not going good. So I need the confidence of the national team to pull me through this season. Right, let's pour it on. Let's get some goals here. I'm looking for at least a 3-1 victory here is what I want. Oh, they got a second burger stand over here hidden away. They got another one over there, so maybe their ratio's a little better. It's hard to see with a small stadium, though. There it is. There it is. Martinez. So 15 minutes, it's already 2-0. Alright, this is gonna go good. There it is, bang. I mean, not the most vicious strike you ever saw, but hey, it worked. Oh boy, these guys are not good at all. They're not even ready for their own kickoff. Smith, come on. Wow, my defensive midfielder Tasovic is way up in there. He is way up front. Maybe I should switch to a controlling. I will at half, I think. I'll switch to a controlling. Or if we get up too much. Just gonna let that one slide by. watching a game earlier today and a coach got kicked out. And then he tried to keep coaching and they had to like escort him out the tunnel. It's pretty funny. Ooh, good shot there. Serrano. I think I should have prepped a little more for this game. Come up with some topics to talk about while we blow these guys out. I didn't think about that. Boom, Dudek. Alright. Alright, let's watch this. It was Martinez to Dudek, right? See, look at that. He just went right around that guy's tackle. Too easy, too easy. Alright, let's do some changes here. Let's go to control, lower, boop, boop, stay on feet. That's fine. Oh, well, they're trying to score here. Nope. Nope, nope. Alright, so of course that might make them get desperate and more penalties and more shots and more goals. We don't want to embarrass them, right? It's all in, so it's a friendly, right? It's supposed to be friendly. There we go. So they released yet another Suicide Squad trailer. They're like really hyping that movie up. Thing about DC now is they, Warner Brothers, I guess, they know how to do trailers. You know, even people didn't like the Batman Superman movie, but most people liked the trailers. Most people were, you know, enthused by the trailers. Now I think it's happening all over again. Suicide Squad, Wonder Woman, Justice League. There was like a crazy Justice League trailer. Almost a goal. And I don't even, I mean, obviously the Justice League movie's filming, but when is that coming out? Like 2017 at the earliest. So I don't know. They seem to be scrambling to save this new DC universe they've created. Putting Ben Affleck in charge of it a little more. Brought in Geoff Johns, the famous DC writer and editor, and now like chief creative officer or something like that. His TV stint hasn't been that great with Gotham. Oops. Serrano sort of walked out of bounds. I think Greg Berlanti has done better with the CW side of DC things than Gotham. Not that Gotham's bad or anything, it's just not the greatest. Oh, I got some 45-minute guys I gotta get out of there, I guess. Oh, Serrano's come to life. That was a good save. So I'm going to have to take Sosa, Wolstein, and Lubon out at half. We got to remember to do that. Don't want their coaches yelling at me. Like the LA Galaxy coach. So many things to think about with this national team. Oh gosh. Wow, good save. I'm going to start cheering for Belize. Go Jaguars, go. I still can't believe Canada's nickname is the Canucks. I'm not sure every Canadian is happy with that phrase being used. I've heard some people consider it derogatory. Maybe it's just used in a derogatory way, I guess. Very happy, keep it up. Instructions fine. Here we go. Alright. So, bring in Warner for Sosa. Cruz. Diaz. See, our defense doesn't lose much when we go to the bench. Even though they hate Diaz. Like, we all know. We all know Diaz is better than that. Anybody else we need to take out? No. We'll save everybody else for halftime. Or, not halftime. 60-minute mark. See who gets tired. Could take Dasovic out. He's got that yellow card, but we should be pretty calm here. Just control the game, not go crazy and get penalties. Alright, let's get some ball control here. Well, let's just friggin' boot it downfield. Do whatever we want. Score goals. Nope. That was a good entry pass, though. Do they call those entry passes in soccer? Is that a hockey thing? Could be a hockey thing. But this is Team Canada, you can use hockey terms, I think. That seems reasonable to me. So yeah, Justice League 2017, alright. That's not terrible, I guess. Not terrible. Let's see. DC movies. Oh, what happened here? I've been watching the game. I hope you're watching. Dudek with a penalty. Boop, easy. Is that a hat trick for him? Yep, that is the hat trick. Been assassin in front of the goal. Yes, he has. 4-0. Go again, easy. The goalie, I mean, if he was any good, he'd have stopped that. He chose the right direction. He just is no good. Nothing he can do about that. Sorry. The first live-action DC movie was Superman and the Mole Men. Theatrically released pilot for the 1950s Adventure of Superman television series. I like that. I like that. So let's see what they got in development. Next year. Wonder Woman isn't until next year either. That's strange. So next year, Wonder Woman, Justice League, Flash, Aquaman, Shazam, Justice League Part 2, Cyborg, Green Lantern, Core. Interesting lineup. We'll see what they got. Not nearly as interesting as Canada versus Belize in a friendly. But hey, can't be all soccer all the time. Got to spread out your views on the world and your entertainment sources. I don't even know. I'm just rambling now. There's a lot of highlights for this, like, there haven't been a lot of dead air times. I think it's because my guys are just getting scoring chances after scoring chances. Still 62 minutes gone. My recording software is covering up the time a little bit, so I can't tell if that's 52 or 62. Let's see, who's tired here? Martinez. Alright, let's get our new guy in there. See what he's all about. Talbert, of course, the old guy is going to be tired. Bring in Wood. And then we should have one sub left for later. There we go. Israel Cantu. Let's see what he's got. Uh-oh, are they going to get a scoring chance here? Is it possible? Nope. Nope. Maybe. Careens off our guys. We're just standing there. And that was terrible. Good job. Please making a substitute. Okay. 67 minutes, so it was 50 before. So we still got a long way to go. That's disappointing. Like to get out of there 4-0 with no injuries. This team has been a little injury prone. People get tired and they get hurt and I don't like it. Messes with my plans. Ooh, get it. Beyonce. Got the pink shoes on today. Kind of goes well with the white uniform. Oh, come on. New guy, Cantu. That was a sure goal. It's not off to an auspicious start there. At least he wasn't offsides. So, I wonder if offsides has something to do with the ability of the defenders as well. Because it must. It's like a defense that's a little better organized will more likely cause people to go offsides, I would assume. So the fact that these guys are not good probably means they're kind of disorganized. Dudek, you could run a little faster there. Good job. Just push that guy out of the way. Oh, wow. Wow. Garbage. I mean, good goal and whatnot, but first goal. But, I mean, that was garbage. He just pushes that guy out of the way, sort of lazily crosses it. The goaltender stands there like a nuke. And I just made up a word there. What word was I looking for? I don't know. I've lost it now. Anyway. I might not even upload this video. It's so terrible. I'm so terrible. Everything's so terrible. Even though we're winning. Just not happy. I'm not happy ever. That's not true. That's not true at all. I'm just can't think of anything to say. I should stop talking. I could speed this up, I think. Highlights. Key. I probably should have done that at halftime, but oh well. It probably won't take effect until after this ball goes out of bounds, just like most things in this game. There we go. Alright, now we should get a little movement going on. Let's get Dasovic out of there first. Before this thing goes out of control. Boop. Alright. Oh, we got some key. Dudek, another run. See, if this guy manages to stay onside, he's pretty good. Ouch. No penalty. No. Jeez. Jeez, guys. Come on, Belize. You could try a little bit. You could try. Hey, look at that. Okay, he knocked him down. That was good. But then, look at that defender just standing there. Standing there like a word I can't think of. I want to call him something. But I just don't know what it is. Hey, there's our guy. That's what we know and love about Dudek. The offside machine. Yellow card for Smith. This should be just about the game here. Unless we score one more. There's time. Not that I'm advocating that, but there we go. Good save, Serrano. And it's even hot in Kansas City. Hot in Topeka. Let's see if you recognize that reference. If you know that reference, then you know references. I'll give you that. Once again, the reference is hot in Topeka. For $500, Alex. Alright, we can end this game anytime now. There we go. 6-0. Oh, somebody just scored in MLS. Boom. Nice header. Ooh, the goalie's not happy about that. Ooh, backflip. Good job. Narrating the television that you can't see. I'm sure that's what everybody loves. Okay, nice victory. Everybody's happy. That's good. Leave the match. See what the Canada stroll to success. Fans sang the praises of their heroes. Wow. A lot of hyperbole going on. Highlight of the game was undoubtedly the hat trick by Daniel Dudek. Anything else interesting? Alright. Good job. Good win. Canada fans purring. 3 goals, 1 assist for Dudek. That's pretty good. I got guys on my team for Toronto that haven't done that all season. Maybe I should hire Dudek. Maybe I should play Belize. Squad reacted positively. That's good. They were in a pretty positive mood. We had our team meeting just beforehand. So yeah, there you go. Team Canada wins again. See you.